What's up, guys? This is MP and this is Yannick. And as you can see, Christoph is on vacation this week, so that's why we are here. And Yannick will tell you a bit about the video we are showing you today.
Yes. We realized actually, like, what did you say? Yesterday or something?
Yes.
Yesterday, that this video right here is the 400th video of this channel, Christoph Magnussen. And that's quite a lot, actually. So we decided we make a little video.
We're gonna celebrate it.
Huh?
You're gonna celebrate it.
We're gonna celebrate it by giving you guys a quick overview, a quick Christoph Magnussen YouTube channel guide. Which videos on which topic are the ones you have to watch if you, yeah, like if this is the first video you see actually from this channel. So we'll give you a quick overview over, in our opinion, which are the best videos for you to understand what we do on this channel and which are quite representative for, yeah, the content we are trying to create right here.
The thing is that this channel doesn't really have a topic. Like, yeah, it's kind of new work, but we also do meditation and phone reviews and stuff like that. So we divided it in a few sections. So we have our tool videos, we have our personal development meditation videos, we have some lifestyle and keynote videos. Workspace is a topic we did quite a while on this channel. And of course we have filmmaking, which is like a essential part of this channel. And I think actually we both can say quite a lot regarding that topic. And we have some highlights really want to show you, videos that were just important to us because it's like, yeah, there's something special about them. So
let's start, right?
Let's start with the tool videos. And I think you will show us the first one.
Yes. So the first video, or actually videos, like plural, searched out for you guys are the G Suite versus Office 365 videos we did. We started with them in 2016, I guess.
Yeah, that was Christoph's first video.
Office 365 versus Google Apps for Work. What is actually the difference and how do you decide which is the right tool for your company setup?
The first one actually was called Google Apps
for Work.
For Work.
I guess that was that's what Google G Suite was called, like before it was called G Suite.
Yeah, we continued this streak right until last year and are looking forward to continue it this year, of course. And last year in 2020 was our biggest project yet. We got many advisors also from our team at Blackboard here to Hamburg and did quite a big round table. We rented some equipment. We did try to do some nice lighting. And it was quite an effort. And I think it was like an hour long or something, like 56 minutes.
Yeah, it was quite
something.
Long. Yeah.
And I would say it's like the most, yeah, most in-depth video of all these comparison videos.
This is the full review and comparison between Office 365 and G Suite for 2020.
I think actually the videos are not like completely just tech focused.
No.
So what I really like about them, this is not a tutorial on which tool you should choose. Our latest video was just a discussion with experts, just discussing what are the benefits of each tool.
Yeah, and how
it
to
wasn't
implement
really
them.
Technical.
Yeah.
I mean, sometimes it's just like how do you feel and what's like what fits better in the company. So yeah,
it's not like which one has the most features or some or the best features or something like that, but more like which one is for which way of working, how to implement them into your company, for example, and all that kind of stuff. We always have two videos for each topic, so I would say in the next one.
Yes, next one we have a video which actually got quite a few views on this channel. It's the how to become a Slack pro in 20 minutes.
This is best practice from, I would say, if you like boil it down to the most important things that we've seen with clients, starting with Slack.
We actually did it here in our studio a few years ago, maybe 1 year or longer, I'm not sure.
I think so.
But it was all empty, no furniture here, and was actually the first video we shot here. So yeah, quite a nice set, and we try to give you, like, if you're new into Slack, just some good content to, like, start into the tool and best practices, how we are using Slack, which channels we use, and some small tips and tricks. And I think I don't really need to say that much more about the video, because that's basically it, and you can check it out if you want. And I think we will link all the videos we are talking about in this corner, somewhere there. Yes, and I think we should move on to the next category, and I will continue here. We will talk about the meditation videos, or like the personal development. We have some videos regarding, like, your work-life balance, meditation and stuff like that, how you can work on yourself to make especially work and life easier for you. And we have a few videos with the Zen master of Christoph, which is Hinak. And we've been there quite a few times in Buchenberg. Mm-hmm. The first one actually got quite a few views as well, and you guys seem to love it, so we are actually planning maybe a few more of those. Spoiler here. And yes, so if you're into meditation, if you like that kind of stuff, you will definitely love these two videos. We have two of them. I think one is 15 minutes, one is 25 minutes meditation. And we actually have another video with Hinak where we talk about fear.
Das tut total weh, dann habe ich Angst. Das ist zutiefst menschlich aus meiner Sicht. Das ist der erste Punkt. Die Angst ist zutiefst menschlich.
So we had quite a nice time there at the monastery with Hinak. I would definitely recommend that video to you, and we will link it as well.
Yeah, and also know. Some props on my side. You did the video
yes.
That time. You edited it and shot it, and it's a quite nice video,
I'd say.
Thank
you so much. Yeah, I mean, we had actually a nice time there, and we packed the Red, we packed the Panasonic, we packed the drone. We actually had everything with us, and
turned out
I think because we had, like, some time there, and we weren't there in a hurry, so we had some time and we just tried to be as creative as possible, and yeah. I think that worked out quite well.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, next one in the category meditation and personal development. A video which gained some, like, traffic in the last year or so, I would say. Didn't expect that, but it was an interview with Andrew Huberman.
Amazing interview.
Because there's a hint there, and it's not really about what you're looking at or you're doing, it's that feeling. Like, learn it. That feeling is your compass.
Amazing interview, like we did it at the EO event here in Hamburg, which Christoph is a part of, and we had some more interviews also, like with the Iron Cowboy, James Lawrence, or Wim Hof, actually, which all are quite good, but I think Andrew Huberman is maybe the best, if you could say so. Neuroscientist and professor at the Stanford University in America. And we teamed up with him, did a little walk in Plant und Blum here in Hamburg. You filmed it with Leon, I think?
Yes.
I edited it later on, and it was a great discussion. Like, actually, we released it also in On the Way to New Work, Christoph Podcast,
yeah.
As a podcast, so you can listen to it also. Maybe we'll link it in the description as well.
Yeah.
And it was a great talk about, I guess, fear was also something Christoph and Tim talked about.
There's something about fear that changes our perception of time.
Yeah, maybe you guys heard of him, like he was on Joe Rogan Experience, I guess, last year or something.
Yeah, and I think that's the point why it gained so much views, because people just started to binge all Andrew Huberman videos.
Yeah.
And actually we got quite a nice few comments from you guys saying that our video really was quite a good one, and there's so much with him out there, so I'm really proud of that. And just one technical information there, we got loads of comments saying, get a stabilizer, it's so shaky. I have to apologize, it was like one of our first videos shooting with a Red, which is not stabilized, so yes, it's a bit shaky, but it's still a great interview.
Yeah, and also it's about the audio, it's about the talk, not about the pictures, but yeah. Great stuff, so watch that one.
Yes, and also at the EO event, as you said, we had Wim Hof and the Iron Cowboy. We have a video with the Iron Cowboy, which is also an interesting talk. He did 50
Ironman in 50 days.
in 50 states.
Yeah, it's
that's crazy.
Like,
and
can't believe it
the Wim Hof thing also very interesting. He showed us like a breathing technique which we filmed. So if you're into that kind of stuff, you can like do it with a video. You can try that breathing technique.
I promise you, you will feel a lot better tonight with a lot more energy.
Very interesting, and I don't think you will find a lot of videos out there where he actually shares like the technique.
No, that's right.
So that's maybe also quite interesting.
And also don't forget about when we are at it, we can say promote also Laura Decker, the podcast.
Yes.
Great, crossed the Atlantic at the age of 14
so
in
crazy.
A sailing boat. And Kai Lissem, like a entrepreneur here from Hamburg.
Yes.
Quite a nice talk as well. So check out the AO videos, all of them are quite great. So let's move on to the next topic, lifestyle and keynotes. And MP will share the videos we sought out of you, for you guys. So let's go.
And the first one is actually quite a personal one for me and for Christoph, I guess, because it was a vlog we did on the way to Kiev, where we, Christoph had a keynote at a Google event.
It will work out. The slides are good, the story's good. It's something totally different than what they had today all day long. Pretty sure it will work.
And it was interesting because Christoph developed a new storyline, especially for that event. And it was quite a bit more personal than the storylines of keynotes before. And he was a little bit like, maybe nervous is the right word. It was just a crazy vibe. I mean, when you check out the video, for me it was the first time actually in Kiev, and we drove there with a driver to the location and had some, I wouldn't say deep talks, but it wasn't that
it
normal
wasn't like,
stuff, you know? And
yeah,
it was quite special. I think it turned out amazing. I love the location, I love the city, and the, from a camera perspective, everything was very, very nice, and also the keynote worked out very well, and it was super emotional. After the keynote, a lot of people came to Christoph and thanked him for the words and for the motivation, and that was really a moment where I thought, wow, this is like actually moving people.
Yeah, and I would also say it's one of the more personal videos on this
for
channel,
sure.
And
yes.
I think you get to know Christoph as a person pretty well in this one. And what all this means to him, like all these keynotes and the stuff we talk about, it's not just something he or we are just talking about to get clicks, to get views, to get I don't know what, but it's actually close to our heart, and I guess it's one of the videos you can tell that by watching it. Yeah.
All right, so we're going to continue. I'm doing another one actually, and I want to talk about the video that we that we named Flow Week.
Instead of talking about flow and theory, this week was a flow week.
We don't really have like a story in the video because I just followed Christoph for like a few days and we did some crazy things.
Some hell of days. It was crazy.
What?
Hell of days, I said.
Yes, for sure. So, I mean, it all started out, I think it was at the at the Online Marketing Rockstars event, I think it was that time frame, where we made that video. So Christoph did a keynote there, and then he planned a podcast, and then he was like, yeah, but my buddy, like, we're going to be like in a plane and record it. What? Okay. And then we actually hopped on the plane of Felix Haas, actually, and recorded a podcast on the plane. I mean, like, this is crazy. It was an amazing experience. I loved that. And also, I'm kind of into that, like...
spontaneous.
That, yeah, and that, you know, that audio quality in the plane.
Okay.
It sounds quite nice. I think we like that.
So. Yeah. Yeah, that's right.
And then we did some other things, the Online Marketing Rockstars party and some more events. I think also at the Vitra showroom we did a thing there. I think it's just like entertaining to watch, and it's kind of a nice video, how the typical week before Corona looked. Yeah, so crazy stuff happening there.
So yeah, let's move on, I guess, to a topic which isn't like currently running on our channel. It was a series we ended a couple, like 1 year ago or something like that, I would say.
We did actually two seasons of that
series. Two seasons. But nonetheless, it was one great series, or two great seasons, I guess, and great content coming from that. And this is the Workspace and People series we did with Katinka in that time.
But then again, the workspace itself is a huge open space. I find those places for me to be less productive.
The point of it was that Katinka came from a like design background. She studied that and wanted to dive in more into the workspace topic all around the globe, actually, not just here in Hamburg or our workspace or something, just to get some inspiration and thoughts on that topic. And so we launched the Workspaces and People series, which in itself developed quite well and got quite far. We did many workspaces. We visited many companies, like, for example, Sony Music. You were in New York. You visited like guys like Dandapani, who is quite a big name in that.
So crazy, yeah.
In that regard.
So, yeah, season one was in New York, and season two was actually in Amsterdam. Yeah, that were the two seasons. Yeah.
Yeah, and we had some quite nice offices to look at.
That's for sure.
It was crazy. Get to know many great people. Like, I remember a keynote which we filmed in that, it was not Workspaces and People, but in that Cosmos, from Jan Tönen, I remember. That was pretty great. Lots of good content, lots of great workspaces, lots of great like views on that topic, workspace, which is something that developed right at this time still, with the home office topic now during Corona, during the pandemic. And many great insights into that, I would say.
I think it's more important than ever, like, to talk about workspace, and especially now. So yeah, I think we would recommend you to watch both trailer. We did a trailer for each season.
Yeah.
And then you can like decide which is like interesting for you, and you can dive into the episodes. We have a lot of episodes per season. Yeah.
Yes.
Next topic: filmmaking.
This is our topic, but also Christoph's also like filmmaker by heart.
That's true. Yeah, Christoph actually, he did like a few years ago, he was like really into filmmaking, and I think he's getting back there. I mean, like, he was more focused on the company for sure in the last years, but I think we are now going back a little bit into the filmmaking stuff.
And we had some quite nice projects regarding that. First one we want to talk about are actually two videos about switching from Adobe Premiere to DaVinci Resolve. Yeah, the first one is like funny, I guess.
I mean, at least we tried to be funny.
Number three. We just get used to it.
Yeah, it was kind of a joke idea, I guess, but the message behind it was real. Like, we didn't say bullshit or something, but it was nonetheless quite funny to make it.
And quite sad, actually.
And quite sad too, yeah. We switched like in 2019, we finally switched from Adobe Premiere and the Creative Cloud, although we use tools from the Creative Cloud,
but of course, Premiere, After Effects,
Premiere especially. Yeah, it just didn't work out. We didn't like it anymore. There were too many problems, too many bugs, which didn't make it possible to work with it anymore. So we actually switched to DaVinci Resolve Studio, which we are still editing on today.
Sorry, but we have to say, like, the comments, you guys, agreed to us a lot. So we're not the only ones who like have problems with Premiere Pro.
No,
so
that's right.
That makes me quite happy, so that's not our fault.
And after we switched to DaVinci Resolve, we Yeah, did a little follow-up. Just told you guys what our opinions are, what we liked about the program, and what are some problems with it. Spoiler, there are not that many problems. It still works great till this day. And it also got quite some views, I guess.
Like
80K or something like that. And yeah, like MP said, you guys said it was the right decision, and we are not the only ones who thought about that and actually did the transition from Premiere to DaVinci Resolve. And yeah, we really recommend it for you. If you're into that kind of stuff, filmmaking and the tech behind it, just check it out.
Yeah, we have a lot of videos there. We have this video, and also like we have videos where Christoph talks about his small camera setup. We have a lot of photography Leica videos, so there's loads of that more, but we just wanted to highlight that video because Resolve, like, it's a big part, and you guys seem to like it, so
yeah, it's close to our hearts.
That's true. And Resolve is still developing, and we are still happy, actually, so let's see how it goes.
So the next video, actually, we are talking, okay, this is getting kind of crazy because we are talking about a premiere before we talk about the movie. So we made a movie about a movie premiere. Yeah, it's complicated, but stay with me. So we actually produced a movie about HYROX, which is a sport competition founded here in Hamburg. And we documented their first world championship. And I actually just shot the interviews. So I wasn't at the championship because I had actually other plans. So I couldn't make it, unfortunately. But Leon and Christoph shot the championship, I guess, right? Yeah.
Yeah, I think so.
And then we edited the video, and that was the point where I got involved again. So Christoph and me, we sat down and had quite a few weeks where we did a lot of editing and just booked us a room somewhere here in Hamburg and just edited all day long. So that was quite crazy, and it was a lot of work, and I have to say, like, I never edited like a short movie or stuff like that, so it's not something that I was used to. So we just started editing and we didn't really know where it was going, so yeah, that was quite a crazy time. And actually, fun fact, we edited with Premiere Pro. Wasn't that nice? So I actually was so exhausted from that I booked my vacation while I was editing, and I edited the movie until, like, I don't know, 3 a.m. in the morning before the day of the premiere.
Yeah, and I remember some render errors.
Yeah, so many render errors was, like, actually a pain. So it was done like at 4 a.m. and at 7 a.m. I flew to the vacation destination, so I was like gone. So I actually also didn't make it to the premiere of that movie, but that's why we have a video of it, and I could watch the video and so that I could see how it went, and it turned out quite nice.
And also we put it in this list, like, because as we said in the beginning, Christoph always tells about himself that he is CEO by profession, yeah, and filmmaker by heart. And it's again one of those videos where it gets pretty personal also for him, because it was such a huge thing for him to premiere this movie, into which so many hours of work and so much blood, sweat and tears went into it.
And he was, like, actually very, very sick while we shot the movie, and he still made it to, like, be there and do it. And at the championship, like, he was better and he was okay, but, like, Christoph grabbing the camera and just going and shooting and stuff like that, and even though he didn't really learn that, you know, but because, like, we learned it, yes, we have, like,
It's our profession.
It's our profession to do that, so. But Christoph is, like, more of a storyteller, and for him it's important, like, to tell a good story and to still do that in a good quality. But it's interesting to see him work actually with that, so that was actually quite interesting. So the HYROX movie is one of our biggest projects, as Yannick said, and actually I think we talked enough maybe about it right now, because it was a lot of shooting days, a lot of editing days, hard work, and I think it turned out great. It's quite long, actually, and we had some problems with editing with the footage, but I think we learned so much from that movie, and it's still one of my favorite project?
Yeah, so we like slide it into the highlight section of this video with the Hyrox film. And now we are getting to the, like visiting of the godfather of new work, Fridtjof Bergman.
Man kann wirklich das sein, was den Menschen stärkt, anstatt ihn schwächt.
Michael Trautmann, like the podcast partner of Christoph, Christoph himself and MP, visited Fridtjof Bergman in Ann Arbor in the hospital to record the 100th episode of On the Way to New York.
Yes.
And did a little video about it. Like I think 4 minutes long or something, not that long, but still, yeah, from a production standpoint, one of the nicest ones, I guess, and one of the ones I can still watch to this day and get some goosebumps from it, even though I wasn't there. And yeah, I guess it's, we put it also on this list because Fridtjof, who actually died a month ago or 2 months ago, in May of this year, Fridtjof himself and the topic he worked on for his whole life, nearly, like new work, he invented the term new work and had many thoughts about it, did many, wrote many books about it and actually lived it to his day he passed. Actually means a lot to us personally, but also a lot to Christoph personally, but also to the company we work in, like with Blackboat, and we try to live this new work style of working like as well as we can do, and try to pass on like the thoughts Fridtjof had. And we visited him last year, right before the pandemic, in February of 2020. We as a team, MP, Tessa, Christoph and me, flew over to Ann Arbor one last time and interviewed him and also filmed some stuff. And it was one of the greatest trips of my life, I would say, and one of the most impactful for me as a person and for me as a, like filmmaker, but also, just as a person, like in private also. And it was very, very interesting and very, just great stuff. And I guess this video we put on this list like captures the spirit of Fridtjof and the things he tried to do and the things he worked on pretty well. And if you see this video and like it and like the spirit of it, I also recommend listening to the podcast, the 100th episode of On the Way to New Work. Because it's just it's just great. And
we have to say it is in German. It's a German podcast and it's a German video. We subtitled the video, of course, so you can like read through it. But the podcast will be in German. But I mean, we did like, it was interesting because we did like the vlog kind of style, even though it was such a big trip. The last time we went to Fridtjof Bergman, we did more of a documentary style of shooting and packed the big cameras. So the first one actually was quite interesting because we didn't know what to expect. It was the first time meeting him, and both of the trips were very emotional for us. It's definitely a video that you should check out because it's one of the most important to all of us, I guess. Yes.
Last one.
We're talking about a video that is that maybe cannot live up to that expectation now, but I want to talk about a video we did also in New York. It was the podcast trip. Also a few years ago, we went there with Michael Trautmann and we did some podcasts in New York. We called them the New York Tapes. It's like a sub-series of the On the Way to New York podcast. And so I just really enjoy the video because it was like, I think the first of that like bigger kind of videos where we like put actually a lot of effort in it. We traveled and it's not like
it's not normal for a podcast to like be followed with a camera in New York. I mean, also that's for me something very special, because to be able to do that and to do those kind of things actually means a lot to me. And I think the video turned out very nice to describe the trip. And also there, those episodes are in English. So if you want, you can listen to the New York Tapes episodes from the trip on the podcast. It's actually, they're also very good. And I don't think we published a lot of them with videos, but we did publish, for example, the Dashlane podcast and stuff like that. Also, we have some videos there. And I wanted to say, actually, and I'm just thinking about the Fridtjof Bergmann video. We have the first podcast fully on camera, actually, but it is still unreleased.
Okay.
We have just the 3-4 minute video. So I don't know, maybe we will publish it. So those are the most important videos, I guess. And I guess also so. I want to talk about just a little thing here about Discord, which is kind of my responsibility to like build the channel there. And we are trying to like find a way to communicate with you guys better, with the audience of this channel, to make content that you actually enjoy. And we are in the process of developing this channel further, and we're working on it, but the Discord server still has, as many of you may notice, has very little like discussion on there. So because like we are, I think we just broke the 200 people on Discord, which is very nice, but we are still thinking about ways of how to interact the best with you and do some like maybe giveaways and some questionnaires and stuff like that. So we are working on it. There still is not that much content on Discord, but if you have any idea how we can develop that further, I would be very happy if you could share it. Just hit me up here in the comments, or I think we can also like find other ways if you want to contact me and yes. We can talk about Discord. Maybe actually Discord. Thanks, Hanno. Yes. Yeah, just hit me up there and we maybe can talk. So I just wanted to tell you, if you want, okay.
We are not giving up.
Help me.
We are
not giving up. It's a first for all of us for Discord and stuff
yes,
like that.
Yes, and so. Still, I guess it's still like a free service. You don't have to pay anything or something like so. Join it, and we are on it. We are getting better. We are getting used to it, and still looking for the right ways. So, don't be too harsh on us. But we are getting to it. So, yeah, I think that's it. It's time to say goodbye, and for you to watch all the videos we just talked about. So, maybe then subscribe and watch all videos we publish next time again with Christoph. You can watch another video here or there,
here,
I guess.
Here, in the middle.
In the middle?
Yeah.
Okay. You can watch another video here. Subscribe to Christoph's channel, to our channel. And yeah, maybe we see each other.
Thank you so much. That was the 400th video.
400th video, yeah.
Crazy.
Crazy. And still going strong.
We won't stop.
We won't stop. So, bye bye, and see you guys.